All right, what is going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's Super here, and welcome to the final Combat Pack 2 character tutorial. Basic character tutorial, can't forget that. Of course, our third and final character is Melina. Now, Melina was actually, by the way, this girl needs a dentist, and I think this is the class we're going to use, because it's the same as my variation number one, which, in my opinion, is probably the best combination that she has. Low Psi. It's always good to have a low projectile. It's definitely not as fast as MKX, but you can still mix people up who don't have the best reactions, like myself. Low Psi, always good. Crushing Blow if you go under your opponent's projectile and hit them with the meter burn. Does good damage. This one right here, the Stabby Stab, really good. Command grab. Well, actually, it's not a really good command grab. It's just a command grab. It's always nice to have a command grab. And the last but not least, I think is something that should always be included in a Melina variation, which is the playtime. This allows her to get extensions for different combos. And this sort of gives her some mix-up potential with some of her combo strings that lead to throws. Not only that, but she gets an extension off of her forward four, which lets you cancel the overhead, which is really good. So let's go into training mode here. Let's talk about Melina. Leave a like on the video if you enjoyed these character tutorials. So I found Melina to be very fun. It just seems like her gameplay just flows really well. I don't know if it makes any sense or not, but when I was playing her, she just feels very smooth, very very fun to play. She has her combo strings that are really good. They're pretty obvious, and you could play around with them, especially with the move that lets you, you know, get, which one is it, this one, get you some of these throws. Ow, his eyes. Well, yeah, he does have eyes underneath that. Here we go, Melina. Stand one, 8 frames, not the fastest in the world. You know, it is gonna be your fastest punish whenever you wanna go for the roll. The good thing is that, you know, you could get pretty much really good damage off of any touch. That was almost 30% off of your 8 frame, you know, fastest button that you have, or fastest punish that you have with Melina. So that's always good. If you don't wanna commit to it, you can maybe go for this. You know, throw is still not safe, obviously, but it gives you a little bit, you know, if you're not comfortable hit confirming into this, or if you don't think you're gonna punish and you just want to, you know, do something, it's always good to go with this. Plus, this gives you a little bit of a mix-up option whenever you are on offense and your opponent's like blocking this. They might think you're gonna do that. You go with your random ball roll. Melina's all about taking chances, in my opinion. Obviously, you could play her very, very safe, kind of like Master of Souls Ermac. You can play Master of Souls Ermac really, really unsafe and take the chances to mix your opponent up. Or you could play it safe. Melina, you could play her both ways. It doesn't really matter. Whatever your choice is. I'm playing her like a scrub sometimes, and I'm throwing out these random ball rolls when I think my opponent might try to avoid my grabs. So that's the positive thing about that. We'll talk about that move later. Her back one right here, it has almost no range, but it's not meant to have range. It's meant to be like a combo ender, and it's also meant to be, you know, something you check your opponent with after a down one, for example. What's her down one? They increase the hit stun on a lot of these, and they increase both hit stun and block, you know, disadvantage, because they didn't want you to just be mashing on your pokes, MK11 to be like just poke, 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 poke like it was before. I haven't played enough of it to see if it makes a difference, but you know, if you get a down one, that's your plus 13 on hit, so that means you get a free back one. Not only that, but you have 3 frames of leeway to actually make it a, you know, 10 frame advantage. So this is a really good combo ender. Obviously, if you finish your combo, if you finish a 6 hit and making that the 7th hit, you know, if you finish a 7 hit combo, whatever, with this right here, you're gonna get that crushing blow, which allows her to pretty much get 30% damage easily And you're not even going to be doing that. Most of the time, you're going to be maybe getting this, maybe getting this. So you're going to be getting easily 35% damage pretty much every game. It's guaranteed as long as you get the hit. So her back one is good. It's really good because it's meant to be like, you know, a checking tool. It's meant to be used from really up close, which is, a place where Melina shines. Now, this move right here, man, this move is pretty crazy. It's a high, right? But it's a, you know, almost character length forward advancing high that leads into, I believe, a safe combo string. I don't think it's safe because I think you could duck the overhead. But you could just do, where is this? Oh, forward 1-2 is actually safe. Wow, so it does lead into a safe combo string. Obviously, you can't cancel anything off this combo string, but the fact that it's safe and it's like this forward advancing is really good. And it also leads into, you know, the combo that I showed you guys, which is a, you know, down 2 into this right here. It gives her some really, really good combo potential. And it's just something really good to check your opponent with, too. You could also, you know, use it to whiff punish your opponent, go into your roll. You could use it to go into your command grab too. It's a really good button. 9 frames, man. That's really good for the amount of range that it has. What's her stand 2 again? Okay, stand 2 is like this double hitting move that also goes into this right here, which this combo string is not bad. I think it has another ender too, right? Yeah, it has that ender. Let's see. What is that? Unblock. So it's +1, but you can flawless block it. But it doesn't really matter because this is safe right here. This is safe. And then this is +1, but you can flawless block it. So she has a lot of combo strings that are useful to her gameplay. You know, all this. Look at that. 30% for any touch. It's really good. Let's see. What else does she have? Her back 2. Okay, so her overhead is not the fastest in the world, but when you're playing online, honestly, I'll probably get caught by this all the time, and I'm sure you guys will too. And she has a bunch of lows that she can mix you up with. So this is the range right here. It's character length, right? Character length. You know, if you're from this far away, you could get a forward 2 just a little bit inside. If you're at this range, you could go for a sweep. And you could also go for her back 3. So there's a lot of ways to mix your opponent up with Melina, with the overhead option and also this option, and of course her sweep. Is her sweep unsafe? No, it's -5, so completely safe. You get all those little mix-ups right there. You're not going to do the most damage, but you're going to annoy the living hell out of your opponent, and that's what it's all about. Forward 2, this move right here, you know, obviously you could go into any sort of special move that you want. So that's really good. If you punish a high attack, you will actually get this crushing blow right here. And then of course you could go for, you know, any combo you want. Let's actually finish the combo. I said let's actually finish the combo. You know, you can go for any combo ender that you want. I believe in that situation, you could actually go for your back 114 crushing blow ender, right? Let's see. Let's test it out. I don't really have the timing for it right now, but I'll give myself a couple of tries. Let's see. One more try. One more try. I like trying out combos. Okay. So that does work. I know it works because, you know, if this works, this one is going to work as well. You just have to get used to the timing because you have to catch your opponent high enough in the air to actually do it. But you can't do it too early because then you're going to miss your opponent. So practice the timing on that. I got to do it myself. Her down 2, pretty standard. Let's see, what's her stand 3 again? I don't use that. Oh, actually, you know what? I do use that because 15 frame startup, you know, it has a pretty good amount of range. Like, it doesn't have the best range in the world, but it's something that you could throw out there with this combo string right here that goes into an overhead. This is actually like one of her best combo strings to start off your combo with because it doesn't scale it as much as something else. like a, you know, 1-1 or a stand 2-2, stuff like that. Obviously, this one's your best, right? You'll get the most damage with this. Compared to this, let's see. No, you could actually get more damage with this, I believe. So, you know, this is something, if something is like very, very unsafe or you're at like this range. Ooh, not even that range. Wow. Okay, this is actually doesn't have as much range as I thought. But, you know, if you get a punish situation, you could obviously go for that. You could go for this mix-up as well if you're up close. You know, instead of this overhead, you can go for the lows. Her down three. So her pokes aren't like the best in the world. Her down three has a ton of range, but I think it's unsafe on block. Yeah, it's minus eight, so there's actually people that could punish it. I think Sub-Zero Slide could punish this. Her down four is not bad, but, you know, the pokes will do. The pokes will do. Stand four, what's this? Fucking spin around the world kick. Trying to copy Rain. Her sweep is a double hitting low. That's really good. And then this right here is pretty much like the bread and butter of Melina. This right here is a double hitting mid. Kind of reminds me of Sindel's cartwheel, just that not as good. But this move right here is pretty much the bread and butter of your offense because it has so much range. It's actually pretty easy to hit confirm. Actually, it's not like the easiest, especially in crunch time. But what the extensions allow Melina to do is get this extra cancel move, because normally this overhead just knocks down, but when you add the custom variation, this one right here, it allows you to get extensions for combos, and forward 4-3 is definitely one of them that really benefits from it, because this is way easier to confirm than something like this. Keep in mind though, this right here is unsafe, like the overhead, if you just end it there, it's unsafe. But it allows you to go for, you know, potentially more deadly mix-up, because you could go for this. It'll open up this a lot more because your opponent's going to know that you're going to want to go for the overhead in order to get this big damage. So just having the ability to cancel it really helps you out. Not only that, but it leads into a restand if you meter burn it, right? Yeah, if you meter burn it, it leads into a restand, and then you could go in for your offense. It doesn't do that much, like the restand doesn't do that much damage. It's just you're spending your resources to restand your opponent. In the corner, though, it'll be really good. So the other moves that I have here, or let's just talk about the basic moves. Pretty much those are the combo strings that I use. You know, this right here. Of course, you go with this. This low right here, it's completely safe. Forward two. You know, you can mix it up with the sweep, and you can mix it up with back two, and of course the bread and butter is this right here. You could also go with this too, completely safe. So those are the combo strings that I use with her. Now, the only thing that I have here that is in the default loadout is the teleport. Always good to counter projectiles. You know, she already has good zoning with the low size, but then if your opponent is trying to counter your zoning, you could always go with the telekick. Not only that, it does 12% on the meter burn. It does, what, 7% normally? It leaves you at a good frame advantage, right? No, it's actually only minus one or plus one hit advantage. So you're pretty much reset back to neutral, but it's always good to have some sort of teleport. And you know what? If your opponent's trying to counter zone you in crunch time, that 12% is really, really good. Just having a teleport in general is really good. So the other one, obviously, the ball roll. You have another move where you have a different variation of the ball roll, but this one does the most damage. So in reality, it's kind of a waste of a slot. Like, she already has a telekick to sort of avoid projectiles. Like, the point of that one is it bounces up, so then it would like go over a projectile and hit your opponent, and then you could still get a combo. But you could go under your under a projectile here, and also you have this telekick. So I don't know, man. I don't know about the other Melina ball roll. Let me know in the comments if you guys have found good use for it. But ball roll, always good. 13 frame startup. It's a good anti-air. Not like insane like it was in MKX, but it's still a good anti-air option for her. because I haven't found like a good anti-air tool, like a stand one, stuff like that. Seems like it whiffs or like it gets beat out pretty cleanly. Maybe down one. I haven't really experimented with anti-airs with her, but ball roll is always a good option. All right, so the extra moves that you get, 1-1, 1+3. This leads into a grab. And your opponent, obviously, they could duck it or they could jump over it. They can't interrupt it with, you know, a poke or a special move, stuff like that. But if your opponent knows that you're going to do that, you know, you can maybe potentially go for this. And if they're trying to jump, then it's going to catch them. I think that this is definitely not triple block strength. So if you go for this, you know, your opponent could still jump over you if you try to do that. So you have to commit to this if you actually want to, like, mix them up. If not, I think you could do that. 1-1 is completely safe, right? Most 1-1s are safe. Yeah, it's only -2. Actually, that's a pretty good stagger. Only -2 is really good for staggering combo strings. So the next one is forward two, three, 1+3. This is just, you know, if you want to end your combo this way, you could end your combo this way. No problemo. Now you could go for this. You could actually do a jump in, right? Maybe a jump one. I don't have the timing for these moves because I don't go for those combos. But you know, well, easy crushing blows on. You can't do that, ladies and gentlemen. But you could end your combos if you want with this move. But I don't see the point in doing it. Unless you want to switch sides, but I think you could, you know, it serves you better to switch sides with this. I believe the switch sides, right? Yeah. So there's real no point in, you know, doing this. Unless, you know, you just want to style your opponent because it looks cool. Other than that, let's see. This move right here, of course. Forward 4-3. Like I mentioned this already because this is like the main reason why I think it's a must to always have this specific move because it allows you to cancel the overhead portion of that into the ball. So you get that mix up of, you know, maybe your opponent's just blocking low. A lot of people tend to block low, right? So they get caught just by the random overhead. Happens to me all the time. So you don't even need to mix them up sometimes. They'll just get caught by the random overhead. And the fact that you get to cancel it always helps out because normally you can't cancel it. So you can't even really go for this mix up because the string is unsafe. Of course, I told you guys it ends with a, you know, grab. You're on a corner, swap them as well. If you don't have, you know, access to this command grab that I have. So this move right here, I think, is always a must for Melina. So you got the low size. I don't see how this... I think this one is probably a must as well. Like, I think these three moves are, like, the perfect combination for Melina because you get the best of both worlds. You get zoning and you get up close action. But the low side, like I mentioned, always good to have. You could get this mix-up going if you want. You know, throw in some of this, you know, might surprise your opponent. But mostly this right here. Not bad. You could do this if they're, like, you know, maybe just trying to duck it. That'll definitely catch them. But the low sides are just, like, really good. And last but not least here is the command grab. I have it because I like command grabs and the animation looks absolutely insane. But I feel like the first two moves that I talked about are must-use moves with Melina. I feel like those should be like staple moves because she has the run. You know, she has a run that replaces the ball roll. That move I use and I'm like, I can't see why I would trade ball roll and my combo potential for, you know, a low attack that the run where you could hit your opponent low and you could cancel it, but it's so much recovery on it. Your opponent could punish you when you're trying to cancel it. There's no other move that I see that's good replacing the ball roll. Maybe the other ball roll, but definitely not the slide. And as far as any other moves, I can't really think of any right now that would beat the first two that I talked about. But with the command grab, if you don't want a command grab because, you know, you really don't need it when you have this ender and you have this ender right here, you know, you could play around with whatever you want. You could use the invisibility, which sucks. You could try out the air size if you want, you know, have air and ground control. There's different things that you could do, but I feel like the first two are definitely a must. So, you know, the command grab, this one right here, it's pretty much a high throw. It's kind of like this right here. Your opponent could duck it. Your opponent could obviously jump over it. So you're gonna have to be careful on when to throw this out. How much damage does this do? Okay, actually does less damage than a throw, right? This does 12? 13. So the command grab does less damage than a throw. So getting in like neutral, you know, you might as well go for a throw because, you know, the command grab is a high. So other than that, I mean, the bread and butter combos for Melina are the ones that I showed you already. I think, you know, something like this. These are like the best combos that you could get with her. For the down two, obviously you could go for the crushing blow. Let's see if I can get it. I actually have not practiced this specific combo, but I know about it. This will get you about 50%. Down dose. Yeah, I might not get it just because you actually do have to practice this timing. There you go. So you have to catch your opponent high enough. You know, you do have to practice to get that timing. It's not the hardest in the world, but it's just like muscle memory. It just takes some practice. And this right here is what I normally go with because, you know, sometimes I fail the input of the command grab after this. So just go with this. This is a really good combo. It does a good amount of damage. You know, any touch gets you 32% or about 30%. It's really hard to drop that combo because this move is so fast. Other than that, I think that's it. In the corner, she really has like the same combos in the corner, right? If you have the air side, you could get a couple of extra, like, you know, damage, a little bit more damage with this. If you launch your opponent, jump three into the air side is not bad. But other than that, let's see, does that work? I wonder if that works or not. Do you guys think that works? I don't think so. I think too much gravity has been used up already. I remember I had seen a combo on Twitter, someone doing like this and then ball roll. What was it for? What was it for? I don't remember. I don't remember what it was with. Maybe it was something like this? I think it was something like that. But that's a cool combo right there in and of itself. Like, that, I like that combo, actually. Anything that has like some cool little extensions look really cool. I think that's what it was. I remember seeing something on Twitter. I'm like, damn, that kind of looks pretty cool. If not, then, you know, just came up with a little combo here. Like I said, this is only day two, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm like, I'm having fun just like trying to come up with some combos here. But this is going to be the end of the tutorial, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed it. Other than that, I mean, her fatal blow, you know, it's pretty standard. You could get any sort of, you know, pop up into her fatal blow. You know, anything like that will definitely work. Actually, you know what? The forward two will work with that, right? Yeah. So that works right there, some style ending with the fatal blow. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I'll see you guys next time.